You've just been invited to compete in the next gladiator game. But wait, how do you know if you have what it takes to beat Gerard Butler? Don't worry, I'm going to share with you a technique to assess if you have the right seat. Let's start with a decision tree. A decision tree is used to classify data. This supervised machine learning technique is a map of possible outcomes based on how a previous set of questions were answered. You can simply think of a flowchart. We'll start at one point and we'll follow a path until we reach a specific outcome. I'll show you an example shortly. But if we think back to earlier in the video series, Shaylee Davis taught us that decision trees are prone to overfit. Head over to Elder Research's YouTube page if you want to learn more. But for now, to avoid overfitting, we're going to need more than one tree. In fact, I'm going to show you how to build a random forest so that you can determine if you have what it takes to win the gladiator. Let me first introduce you to the lineup. Here, we have 5 gladiators, including Gerard Butler. And with each gladiator are specific characteristics and their score. We're going to be evaluating gladiators based on their strength, their speed, they're injured or not, and what their age is. With this data, we can build a random forest to determine what makes a gladiator victorious. So let's imagine that we have an arena. We're going to randomly select gladiators from our data set to put them in this arena. We'll take Gladiator 1, we'll take Gerard, and let's take Gladiator 4. We'll go through this process of randomly sampling with replacement many, many times. And this process of creating random subsets is called bootstrapping. Let's focus on our first set. With each subset, we're going to create independent decision trees that each gladiator will be evaluated on. What I mean by that is that this random sample will be evaluated on this decision tree. And this decision tree was created by randomly selecting features from our data set. So here we're looking at strength and speed. Now to evaluate the gladiators, let's go through the process together. For Gladiator 1, we'll ask ourselves, does Gladiator 1 have a strength greater than 3? Yes. Okay. Next we'll ask, does Gladiator 1 have a speed greater than 3? No. So it doesn't look too good for Gladiator 1. But how about Gerard? Okay, does Gerard have a strength greater than 3? Yes. Does Gerard have a speed greater than 3? Yes. So it looks like he'll move on to win this round. And I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, okay, but what about me? How am I going to compare? What characteristics do I need? Don't worry. Let's assume you're like me, and you're pretty strong, you're kind of fast, you're not injured, and you're in the prime of. We're going to take this new data point, and we're going to evaluate it on each tree that's been created. So again, is the strength greater than 3? Yes. Is the speed greater than 3? No. Well, you can't win them all. Okay, how about this next tree? Is the speed greater than 2? Yes. Am I injured? No. Another, my first victory. Lastly, what about this last tree? Is the strength less than 4? No, I have a strength of 4, so I'll win again. Once this new data point has gone through each of the decision trees, we'll use a process called aggregation to assess the final outcome. What I mean by this is we'll take the majority of the outputs from the decision trees evaluated, and that will be the final outcome. So I didn't win the first one, but I won the second too. To me, it sounds like I have a pretty good chance in the gladiator games. Now you can assess yourself. But if you're thinking that this application sounds a little bit like ancient history, you're not wrong. In fact, a random forest can be used on a multitude of industries. Let's take the medical field, for example. If we want to know what kind of characteristics classifies an individual to have a disease or not, you can use the random forest. How about in finance? Is Gerard Butler going to default on a loan? With these next steps I'll show you, you can determine your application for the random forest. Again, we're going to take our data set and randomly sample. many subsets with the process called bootstrapping. We'll then fit a tree to each of our subsets. And we're going to ideally do this hundreds of times. And each tree is built based on randomly selecting the features from our data set. Once we've done this, we'll then use the process of aggregation to determine the final output. Now, do you have what it takes to win the Gladiator Games?